Brothers and sisters, if you can carry it, okay. Brothers and sisters, comrades and friends, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum salam wa
rahmatullah. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to the Palestine Solidarity Protest against Israel apartheid, and to thank you for being here today to express your solidarity with the Palestinian people who are still suffering under the Israeli military occupation despite all efforts to bring about just and comprehensive peace to our region. Allow me to take this opportunity on behalf of the Palestinian leadership and the people to acknowledge and express my sincere appreciation to the South African government and people for their unwavering support and solidarity with our people and their just struggle for the realization of their inalienable rights and the establishment of the fully sovereign and independent Palestinian state with East Jerusalem as its capital on the line of 1967. For the last, comrades and friends, for the past seven decades, Palestinians have been subjected to countless injustices and ongoing cycle of destruction, displacement, and disposition. With blanket support from the United States, Israel has been given a free hand to persist in the total annexation and isolation of Palestinian Jerusalem and pursue the flagrant historical, political, cultural, demographic, and geographic transformation of the occupied city, erasing its Palestinian presence and identity. Since the 30th of March, the world has witnessed the illegal action being perpetrated by Israel, the occupying power, against the Palestinian people, in particular in Gaza Strip, in the context of the Great March of Return protests, which are calling for the right of return of Palestine refugees to their homes and towns, demanding an end to Israeli occupation, siege, disposition, and calling for Palestinian independence and freedom. The demonstrators are also protesting the Israeli blockade of Gaza and the unbearable conditions of life there, where 2 million Palestinians, the majority refugees, have been subjected for over a decade to an illegal Israeli land, sea, and air blockade that has vastly compounded the misery and suffering inflicted on the Palestinian people by five decades of Israeli military occupation since 1967 and seven decades of disposition and denial of their rights of return to their homes and ancestral lands since their ruthless uprooting in the Nakba on 1948. While it is natural for any oppressed people to raise up against injustice and to seek freedom, Israel has clearly instructed its soldiers to respond to these demonstrations with lethal violence against the civilian protesters for daring to reject and challenge the occupation and its persecution. This systematic and widespread targeting of unarmed civilians is deplorable and illegal, constructing war crimes and crimes against humanity. Comrades and friends, as a nation under occupation, siege, and apartheid rule by Israel without any form of protection, we need your help to end the last occupation that still exists in the 21st century. We also need your help to break the siege imposed in Gaza. Your support is very important to us and gives our people immense courage and strength and they continue the struggle for freedom, independence, and dignity. The international solidarity movements are playing an important role in exposing and condemning the crimes of the Israeli occupation against peaceful demonstrators, which killed 118 Palestinians and injured 1,330 others since the 30th of March. We appreciate each and every one of you for dedicating your time to give support to the Palestinian people and to send a message to the international community that it must carry out its responsibility of ensuring peace and stability and to act with conscience to bring an end to the Israeli human rights violations against our unprotected Palestinian people and its unlawful occupation and colonization of their land. It is high time that Israel is held accountable in reference to international law, including humanitarian and human rights law, in order to end the culture of impunity that has allowed it to commit such grave crimes against defenseless Palestinian people for too long without consequences.